The MRes for me isn't just about coming in and doing your lectures, it's about an opportunity for students to actually become part of something bigger, so part of a bigger research project, and to try and inspire them to go on and do the very best and be the best that they can in their future careers.
So each student takes three modules in particular subjects. That's complemented by a research skills module that all students take, and then that is all done by mid-January. And then they move into the research project from the beginning of February right through till the end of July.
So I'm doing an MRes in medical and molecular biosciences. So the first few months of the degree, it was just tour modules, lectures. Then after January, so the second semester, we undertake our research project that we chose early on in the year.
So most students who are coming to do the MRes as a standalone year will be given a range of projects in their chosen discipline. And they can then look through that list, decide what interests them, and feedback their choices to the person who's looking after that particular area of the MRes. And they will then sort out the project choices for those students, giving each one a project as close to the top of their list as they can get it to be.
So I'd like to pursue a career in dermatology, and medicine in itself is like really research heavy, but dermatology especially, there's a lot of research in that. So I thought if I get a good basic knowledge and also advanced knowledge of research, that'll get me ahead of other candidates and give me more knowledge about the world of research and dermatology. So basically through Newcastle University, I got in contact with Mark.
I'm a professor of molecular dermatology, but I've also got a spin-out company as well, which is housed here in the Catalyst. The core technology really is to do with a personalized skin DNA damage test. The opportunity for Pratyush to work in skin life analytics, but being part of the university doing an MRes, is the fact that actually he's able to fit quite clearly into a project that actually benefits aging population, skin aging. So again, it provides a kind of shortcut for someone like Pratyush to actually get first-hand experience and transferable skills of what it's like to work in a company, but actually be still rooted in the research.
This is a real life project. So the data that those students are generating is invaluable to our research project, because this is things that we need to do. This isn't something we make up for them to do. This is real life.
I think it's attractive because it allows the student to really see how science is applied in real life. So you're in contact with people that are actually applying science, and it's become their daily job, you know, their livelihood. You can see how the lab work and everything that you're doing can actually impact on the world and society.
What this option does, it gives you a taste of what's possible, and actually breaks down a lot of the barriers in terms of your head and terminology, in terms of, well, it's not as complicated as I thought. So it can be very doable, and actually this provides a bridge for the students to get a taste and experience that.